when heat and cold comes, when birth and death comes, what should you do? Manish?
Face
it.
Face them bravely.
Face them bravely. The word he uses, titiksha. If you can learn this word today, you have learned something. Titiksha means, he says, endure. Tam titikshasva bharata. A beautiful verse, very, very famous. In fact, he is being very, very practical. Very practical. When you go out into the world, you will come across a friend, a foe. There are benefactors out there, there are malefactors out there. There are pleasant times, unpleasant times. There is good, there is bad. There is profit, there is loss. There is health, there is disease. There is knowledge, there is ignorance. There is good, there is bad. In short, doesn't that, what is the word for that? All this is dvandvas, rightly said, is all opposite. What is another word for that? What is that? All I said, maybe it can add more also. What is that? Perhaps you must understand when you are in the best moments of your life, understand their impermanence. Not easier. When they are in the worst moments of your life, understand they are not impermanent. They are not permanent. They are not permanent rather. They are impermanent. While you are going through the worst moments of your life, life can be so challenging. You can ask, why me? Why should I go through this? Understand they are not permanent.
Passing clouds.
Temporary.
Passing clouds, as they say.
Temporary.
This too shall pass.
There is a beautiful poem, "Even This Shall Pass Away," by Theodore Tilton. Theodore Tilton, Google and find out. Vaishnavi, Ganesha, Theodore Tilton, "Even This Shall Pass Away." Nothing in life is permanent. So what I said is, all that we are experiencing in life is nothing but that is your world. That is your world. The world you are living in is good and bad, is profit and loss, is birth and death, is all these opposites. You cannot escape them. This is life. And having experienced life, how well are you prepared to face life today? You have given the best education, you have given the best exposure to your children. But how well have you prepared them to face life?
Only material comfort.
Sorry, sir?
Only material comfort.
You have given them scholastic education, degrees, and graduated them in the best university in the world. Because you can afford it. But have you taught them of what life is all about? It's a different ball game altogether. And I'm not saying you have not done a good job, but you know what, how you stand with reference to this life's challenges. You know. There are people out there who are ungrateful to you. How do you handle that? Yesterday, a couple of days ago, somebody was telling, sorry, Manisha, I was over at lunch with a colleague of mine. And we were in a restaurant where all were IT crowd. And there was a discussion of the corporate life. I'm just summing up what he said is, the corporate life is such that they will laugh, they will smile, they will whine, they will dine with you, but the first opportunity will backstab you. First opportunity comes, they will backstab you. So you can never trust anyone there. It's a very selfish world out there. Nobody is interested in, everybody is in fact interested in your chair. Exploiting. They'll exploit you. They only want your chair. And the moment they get a chance to backstab you or to pull you out of the chair, they'll do that. And they're smiling at you. They're actually laughing poison. I'm hearing that from him. I'm not a corporate person. He's a corporate guy. And he's telling, this is the world out there. How prepared are you? You know, sir?
Full of sharks.
Full of sharks. Right?
Jealous.
Jealousy. Envy. And yet there might be people who are very loving, very concerned, very... And another colleague of mine, she was saying, I will never ever leave this boss of mine. I've been with him for 8 years. I will never even leave. Even if I get half as double the salary, I'm happy with what salary I'm getting. I want to be with him. And there are people like that as well. If I double the salary, I don't want to leave this boss. I'm happy here. Corporate person is saying that. They all want is they want to go higher up the ladder. They want to make big as quick as possible. Now, when you get down to life and living it, how well have you kept yourself through these fluctuations and undulations of life, the ups and downs of life, the good and bad, which is the world, which is the reality, which is life for a matter? How well have you handled it? So life is nothing but a procession of these opposites. In fact, life is opposite. So you should actually gracefully receive profit and gracefully receive loss. Which means you should not be jumping with profit nor be sinking with joy, with loss. If there's profit, don't be jumping with profit. If there's loss, you shouldn't be sinking with loss. Don't be elated at birth or dejected at death.
All for the good.
But how well can you face that when life puts you through is the challenge, is the question mark. How well are you all prepared for what life has been putting you through, will put you through? There is a capacity, isn't it? He's talking about that capacity to endure. Understand that they are impermanent. How to endure them? Understand that they are impermanent when you are going through them. Now what do we do? What is the mistake we do? It's certainly not easy. But when you understand it's a visitor in your life, how would you treat a visitor? Let's say I know you're not invited to me, but I invite myself to your house for discussion sake. I come to your house. You know how good a person he is. He's not really a permanent member, he's just a visitor. You give it the due cordiality. Whatever be my personality, you have got nothing to do with me, isn't it? So what are you? He may be good or bad, right or wrong, I have got nothing to do with him. He is going to come and go. So, to have that attitude to your family members at home. They are also impermanent, not permanent, my dear. So everything in life just comes and goes. So why are you giving it a sense of permanence? No doubt it is the reality now. Now pick up these two words, they are what is known as relative reality. Yes, this classroom is the reality now. 6:33 p.m. is the relative reality now. Come back at 8 o'clock, shut down, nothing is there. Pass, isn't it? Everything in life has got a relative reality. Now what are we doing to it? We are making it an absolute reality. If the problem is this much, you are making it this much. Because you have made it an absolute reality. It is not that big. So this small. From this small you make it this big. Why? You lack the Catholicity of thought. You don't have a Catholic thought. Catholic means you don't have that magnanimity. You can't think big. You're thinking too small. That is the word. Understand, that is the word. So don't complain when the world is hard at you. Never ever complain. Why? That is the swabhava of the world. That is the very nature of the world. So what should you do? Titiksha. Endure it. Endure is not somehow bearing it. Endure means you are able to go through it with pleasure. You accept it with pleasure. You don't have to somehow sail through it. So you got to understand that the desirable and the undesirable are integral aspects of life. Pleasure and pain are part and parcel of life. So when you look yourself in the mirror, how well am I prepared to handle profit and loss? How well is a sportsman able to take a loss? He should handle loss with grace as much as he has handled win. He's lost the game.
That's the spirit of the game.
The spirit of the game. As they say, you must take to life as a prince takes to sport. Prince has got nothing to lose with winning or losing. He just takes to life just for the joy of life. Just for the joy of playing, he just takes to sport. So take to life as a prince takes to sport. Doesn't matter whether you win or lose, whether profit or loss. I just want to be myself. And the problem is, we are obsessed with having pleasurable things in life. We are obsessed. All what we want is pleasurable things. And all what we do is we detest unpleasant things. And therefore, when unpleasant things come, you can't stand. When little bit of bitterness comes, you can't stand in life. Even food. A little less salt. A little less that. No doubt, you don't want to eat unhealthy food. No doubt. But if vegetable is like bitter God, come on, man. It's good for you. Take it. If bitter experiences come in life, don't detest it. Prashad, accept it. So beautiful verse. Very, very practical, very meaningful.